where they're reacting to the president's State of the Union address last evening. President Biden saying he is committed to work with China, but referencing that balloon incident, saying the U.S. will act to protect the country. Eunice Yoon joins us now. Eunice, how is all this being received in China?
Well, in a much more muted way than you would expect, Ty, the Chinese have been downplaying President Biden's critical remarks. The foreign ministry today called on the U.S. to be objective and rational, they say, while arguing that a responsible country would see this relationship as one of opportunity. Now, there's been some speculation that the Chinese may be reluctant to be seen as personally attacking President Biden because of his relationship with President Xi. Now, this more muted response comes amid the row over the balloon, which the U.S. alleges is for spying. Of course, the Chinese deny that, but that President Biden has described as a threat to U.S. sovereignty. And that description really hits a sore spot for the Chinese, who have been striving to present themselves as the one that upholds international rules and is a champion for state sovereignty globally, as opposed to what the Chinese have hinted at is a U.S. that interferes and imposes Western values. Now, the Chinese have not, in response to President Biden's speech, referenced the balloon, but did say that they would defend firmly Chinese sovereignty. Guys?
Eunice, quick question, changing gears just a little bit. It's obviously early in the morning there in Beijing right now. But now that the Lunar New Year is over, what are you seeing and sensing about the vitality, the reopening, the economic activity in Beijing and elsewhere in China?
Well, based on my impressions, first impressions, and after just coming back recently to China, there is definitely more economic activity compared to the zero COVID period. I have seen traffic jams, which I have not seen in the past couple of months before I left. And also there are restaurants that are open late, stores that are staying open as well. So people are out there shopping. There is still a concern about catching COVID, though not as bad from what I understand here in Beijing as compared to a couple of months ago when there was a massive surge. So that has subsided here. Very difficult to say what's going on around the country where the pandemic is still going on and we don't have a whole lot of clear data. But at the same time, what's interesting, I think, is that there has been a lot of discussion about economic recovery, but there's also a lot of discussion about the years of lost income from zero COVID. So that's affecting spending, and I think it's being borne out in some of the numbers that we're seeing. You mentioned the Lunar New Year. The travel numbers looked pretty good. The government said that it was about 90% of pre-pandemic levels, but the consumption numbers haven't been as great, and you can even see that in smartphone sales, the lowest in a decade. And in fact, not a lot of discussion about a recent discount by Apple for its iPhone Pro series, $100 off, but people aren't really talking about it that much. So I think that tells us something about the way the consumers are thinking here.
And finally, Eunice, as we get more reports about Chinese spy balloons making their way around the world, what is the narrative there about this issue?
Well, the narrative is that it's pretty much the U.S. overreacting and that the Chinese are in the right and that this is just a weather balloon.
All of them are just weather balloons?
That's what they're saying. Yep. Mm-hmm.
All right. Have to ask. Eunice, thanks so much. It's good to see you again. We appreciate your reporting today.